Everything's still agog here on Saturday night from Goldberg, but it is time for the main event. The World Television Championship will be on the line. Bit Finlay to defend against Eddie Guerrero.
Well, the arena is still rocking. This is the second half of our championship doubleheader. And this is the challenger, Eddie Guerrero. Look at this, Eddie Guerrero is being led to the ring by his nephew, Chavo Jr.
Chavo looks really happy to be out there today. Eddie Guerrero has held numerous titles, and he wants to have the world television title around his waist. Stay with us!
Go, Chavo! I'm going to teach you a lesson and show you how a champ wins a match. Just like it says that I am your favorite wrestler, because I know I am, and I know I'm everybody else's favorite wrestlers, even these morons here.
Great. This guy's delusional.
I want to prove it to you. So, Dave Finlay, I was very impressed with how you won the television. Yeah, I want this thing. On how you won the television champion, that I am challenging you right now to come out here. That way I could show my nephew and teach him a lesson on how it's done the right way.
Who is Eddie trying to impress?
I don't know, but this is going to be quite a matchup with Fit Finlay against Eddie Guerrero.
Yeah, it's terrific for Eddie Guerrero to come out and challenge Fit Finlay when we've known about this match for the last couple of hours and the contracts have been signed. Yeah, what a great challenge. What a real tough guy you are, Eddie.
And how about this guy, the new World TV champion?
He is
Fit
a tough
Finlay.
Guy.
He certainly is. We've been talking about this brawler from Belfast, Ireland, and I think he finally just received the opportunity that he needed. He got that World TV title shot. A lot of people say that the Canadian crippler Chris Benoit played a major role in that when he came down to ringside.
Yeah, he did.
But let's face it, Fit Finlay beat Booker T.
He did.
No question.
And tomorrow night, Fit Finlay, if he is
but
still the champ.
Nice,
oh, no.
So,
not done yet.
No, listen. So I want to show you some affection, show you what a loving uncle I am. I'm going to let you have the opportunity to become the world television champion.
Wait a minute.
Hey, I'm doing it only because I love you. I knew you could do it, bro.
Oh, that's insane. Oh, come on. Chavo's not ready to wrestle. He's got his gear on, but he had no idea.
He continues to throw his nephew to the wolves.
Oh, that is insane. Eddie Guerrero is on the contract to wrestle Fit Finlay. Is it still a title match? Everything said, Eddie and Fit Finlay. It didn't say anything about Chavo.
Well, looks like Finley's agreeing.
Yeah. Well, Finley's not going to back down, I can tell you that.
No, he doesn't back down from anything. And how about this past Thursday on Thunder when we saw Mondo Guerrero, the brother of Eddie, talk about a family divided.
Oh, yeah.
And all the problems, the wedge in the Guerrero wrestling dynasty because of the man at ringside, Eddie Guerrero.
Everybody has an opinion about Eddie Guerrero, and I don't think anybody likes him except Eddie. Eddie Jericho. I think Jericho likes him.
Some kind of an association there.
Fit Finlay and Chavo Guerrero, after we thought all 2 hours that it was going to be Fit Finlay and Eddie Guerrero, Eddie fails. What a coward. He just doesn't want to wrestle one of the toughest guys in pro wrestling in Fit Finlay. But Fit Finlay giving a little bit of chase to Eddie Guerrero, but Fit Finley's not going to forget. His opponent is in the ring, not at ringside.
Yeah, but things may be looking up for Chavo Guerrero Jr. because tomorrow night at Slamboree, let's put it this way, freedom may be less than 24 hours away for Chavo Jr. because the match has been signed. It will be Eddie Guerrero to face the Ultimo Dragon. You know, the Dragon has actually shown some compassion, some sympathy for the plight of young Chavo Guerrero. And if the Dragon is able to defeat Eddie Guerrero, and we saw him lock on that Dragon sleeper this past Thursday on Thunder, then the ties can be cut, and Chavo will be a free man.
Well, Ultimo Dragon, a native of Japan, his talents, his potential not appreciated when he was a young and up-and-coming wrestler in Japan. He had to go to Mexico to get appreciated. I think he sees in Chavo Guerrero a little bit of himself. Maybe he sees Eddie Guerrero not appreciating the talent, the potential of young Chavo. That's why the Ultimo Dragon, has come to the aid of Chavo Guerrero Jr.
Very focused attack by Fit Finlay here in the early going. Chavo tries to fight back from his knees.
Oh!
lifts him high into the air and just slams him down to the mat. How about that tombstone pile driver of Fit Finlay?
Oh, no thanks.
He's gaining victories left and right, retaining the world's TV title.
When you leave a match with Fit Finlay, you've got welts and bruises and cuts and contusions all over you, like you've been in a bus wreck. But Chavo Guerrero now with the headlock, but oh, Finlay drove him back first into the ring apron.
And you can see that Eddie wants no part of Fit Finlay. Every time Finlay either shoots him a look or Finlay comes out to the arena floor, Eddie Guerrero very conveniently just walks around to the other side. He wants no conflict with the world's TV champion, Fit Finlay.
Tomorrow night, Eddie Guerrero and Ultimo Dragon. The stipulation in this one, no titles on the line, no mask at stake, no mask versus hair, anything like that. The one stipulation, if Ultimo Dragon defeats Eddie Guerrero, Chavo Guerrero Jr. is free of his promise to Uncle Eddie.
And you also have to admit that Chavo has certainly been a man of his word. For the past couple of months, yeah, he agreed to that stipulation, but he certainly has done everything Uncle Eddie's way.
Let's not forget that tonight, Fit Finlay is wrestling Chavo Guerrero Jr., we assume defending the World Television title. We never got the official word. Let's assume that it is a title match. Tomorrow night, Fit Finlay will defend the title against Chris Benoit.
Well, the Canadian crippler earned that. Nice springing move, the bulldog by Chavo Jr. Here's the cover, legs hooked, shoulders are down, but he gets just a two count.
Wow.
This past Monday on Nitro, I guess you'd almost have to term it a number one contenders match. And Chris Benoit defeated Booker T, and as a result, it's Benoit that gains that shot at Finlay in the world's TV title, if Finlay is successful tonight.
Big boot to the face of Chavo Jr. by Fit Finlay. Up into the fireman's carry. Fireman's carry rollover slam by Fit Finlay. And the television champion firmly in control over young Chavo. And Eddie, as you can see at ringside, not happy.
Uh-oh.
Oh, man. Looks like it's a tombstone coming up.
No! Spiked him in mid-ring with the tombstone pile driver.
That's got to do it.
It's academic from here.
The three count, and Fit Finlay retains the World Television Championship. He will go into Slam Arena tomorrow night to defend against the Canadian crippler Chris Benoit, and that man, Eddie Guerrero, will face Ultimo Dragon with the control of Chavo Guerrero Jr. at stake. That's all tomorrow night at Slam Marie. Still plenty of time to call your cable company or satellite provider. Hang on.
Well, first he had the towel over his head as if in total embarrassment. And, oh, this is just humiliating.
Let's stay
enough
with it.
Enough of this already.
Let's stay here just for a second and see if Chavo Guerrero Jr. can fire back on Eddie. Oh, Eddie's right in his face, slapping him. Come on, Chavo.
Yeah, but he's a man of his word. There's the dragon.
Ultimo Dragon. Who will wrestle Eddie Guerrero?
No, don't turn your back on Doc.
Oh, and Ultimo Dragon knows better. Eddie Guerrero opening up on Ultimo. This is 24 hours before their match. Oh, no way. Eddie's making... please. Oh, Chavo, don't.
Well, he's got to. That's part of the stipulation. Oh. He's a man of his word.
Oh, the frog splash. Oh, man.
Yeah, you can see he's shaking his head. He wants nothing to do with this.
Tomorrow night, Eddie Guerrero has to wrestle Ultimo Dragon. Wait a second.
Stop it.
Oh, this has got to stop. This has got to stop between Eddie and Chavo. Fans, we'll see you tomorrow night at Slamboree. Let's go to Mean Gene.
You know, folks, as we conclude this edition of WCW Saturday Night here on TBS, I got to talk what we've been talking about all night long, and that is Slamboree. Coming up at 7 p.m. Eastern Time tomorrow night, live from New England. All of New England will be there. For those of you that can't, of course, you can join us on pay-per-view. A couple of matches that we must talk about. The Macho Man, Randy Savage, going one-on-one with Bret the Hitman Hart. Hart coming to World Championship Wrestling not that long ago, and I'm certain there are a lot of differences that go way, way back between Savage and Bret Hart. Also, all of the divisiveness in the NWO, who knows what's going on there. One thing I do know, WCW and NWO tag team champions Scott Hall and Kevin Nash tomorrow night to defend against Sting and the Giant. You could be part of it. Folks, pick up the telephone right now. Call your local cable company. Direct Ticket also with DirecTV is another address for pay-per-view, as well as the Dish Network. And satellite dish owners, you need to contact Turner Premier. That's tomorrow night, 7 o'clock. Get ready for Slamboree, a spectacular WCW pay-per-view extravaganza. Gene Okerlund for Scott Hudson, Mike today. Good night from Atlanta. We'll see you tomorrow night on pay-per-view.